And then, so you grew up in a family where people knew, loved your father, and they spoke to you. It's like Truman world, that you didn't know everybody was reading about you.
I felt like an alien.
像我小孩平常都是校牌三二一之类的，但是他最近就下滑到是这样。Wait a minute. Wait, what's going on here?
As a drag queen, I have many wigs. It is art, you know, it's performance art, essentially.
Yeah, well, yeah, if you do it right.
Yeah, yeah, if...
It's all, there you go. Thank you. Today we have a very special show coming your way. We have a very special guest. He's one of those people that we all grew up. You guys all grew up in different places. But this, for someone in Taiwan, is very true and dear. His father is a very famous writer. But in his books, we read all about the growing up, growing pains, the growing laughters and tears of this special guest here today. He didn't know anything about it. What, Britney Spears? Justin Timberlake or Macaulay Culkin? No, he didn't know he was famous. So he grew up in the States. His books were everywhere in Taiwan. We all grew up reading it. They were so popular, we put them in textbooks. So everybody knew about him except him. So today he is here on his own because now he is a very successful writer. He is a life coach. He has his own amazing podcast and many, many more. My good friend, Xuan Liu. Good to see you, buddy. Have a sit down. Oh my goodness, haven't seen you in a bit.
Yeah.
How you been?
Been great.
You've been awesome. Not too bad. Yeah. You know, got this new show. I'm so glad that we can squeeze in the time for you to come in and see us on the show.
It's an honor.
Your father to me is one of my heroes. His father is one of the best known modern writers in Mandarin culture.
Thank you.
He's got what, thousands, hundreds of thousands of books. Hundreds,
he has
a few hundred at least.
He has published 115 books.
Oh my goodness, and many of them bestsellers, and a good few of them are about you.
Well, technically speaking, only four.
Only four. Okay, all right. The stories resonate,
the stories,
though,
yeah.
Right? Yeah. And his father is also a painter. And then, so you grew up in a family where people knew, loved your father, and then because of him. And these stories, people fell in love with you. And then you going to school, studying in Harvard, and all those stories were shared with the mass audience that read Chinese. And you told me without you knowing, that must have been a really trippy situation when you one day realized, wow, all these people know me.
That was a period of about 2 or 3 years.
Uh-huh.
I gotta first tell everyone how the books got started.
Okay.
It was because my father and I would have these dinner table conversations. And he would ask me what goes on in school.
Okay.
And back then I was going to school in Manhattan and we lived on the outskirts of Queens. So it would take me a long time to get to school. And every day I would come back really late, right, just in time for dinner. And I would tell him, you know, different things went on in school. And he would always have something to say about it. You know, that kind of like dad knows best kind of deal?
Well, yeah, all dads do, well, we try.
Right.
We try to do that.
Right, I'll give him that, right? But for me, he is someone who is a painter, you know, and a writer.
Yes.
You know, living at home, he works out of home.
Yeah.
So I don't think that he knows the whole situation. So I tell him a bit of something, and then he tries to make a big deal out of it.
Okay.
And obviously, I don't agree with him. So after about almost a year of just this kind of dinner table bickering.
Okay.
One day he shows up with a thick pile of paper and he says, "Hey son, I wrote about all these conversations that we had."
No way, are you serious?
Yeah. So you want to read a couple of pages?
Yeah. How old are you then?
I was 15.
Okay. Well, so you were a teenager.
I was a teenager. So the very first piece was about my first day going to high school. And about me being so nervous, that, you know, I go to the bathroom like several times, and you know, and then I couldn't remember all the subway stops, you know, en route to school, right? And then when I got home, I was really happy because I remembered all the stops then. And he said, "Oh, that is such a great thing. You're grown up." And I looked at that and I said, "What is the big deal with that story?" Right? It's just like, so this is just something
like,
natural to happen.
Dad, what are you doing? Dad, you know, this is my day.
This is my day.
I remember one day he came over to my house to have dinner.
Yes.
And we don't live that far away. You're about 10, 15 minutes away. Your father walked in, and he's always excited, he's full of energy. You know, he's going boom, 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 boom. And then he got in my house, and he started telling me about his walk, his journey from your place to my place, just the walk. And the things that he saw, there was a bird that was, you know, lurking, waiting to catch warm. And
then there's some flowers he wanted to paint.
Yeah, yeah. And then he's like, yeah, and then they just planted those flowers, and the flowers are so beautiful. And then, I'm going to try to find Dad, I'm going to go paint. He's, you know, very, very excited. But what I've noticed is he's really observant. Mm-hmm. So he'll pick up on things. Mm-hmm. So I guess that's why raising you being his pride, the son, he must observe everything about you throughout your life.
Yeah,
right?
No pressure, right? Yeah, it was really easy growing up. Hey.
Okay. Yeah, no pressure at all. The stories that his father wrote were so popular, they were implemented into the textbooks of Taiwan. So we would read about his stories in textbooks. So meaning every person growing up here read about it. And finally, somebody said, and then they spoke to you. It's like the Truman world. You were like a Truman, that you didn't know everybody was reading about you. Is that true?
I kind of knew that the books did well.
Okay.
But I didn't know how well. Until my first time coming back to Taiwan. Now, I was born in Taiwan, but I left when I was 8 years old.
Dang.
And we moved to New York and grew up there. So my first time coming back was when I was 19. And, you know, Taiwan during the 80s boomed, right?
Yeah.
It was an economic miracle.
Yes, it was happening, yeah.
Literally could not recognize my own house. Couldn't find my own house.
What do you mean?
On the same street.
The entire street
looked completely different.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
And obviously the whole culture was very different. And I felt like an alien. And the first time I came back, they arranged for a little meet and greet with some of the readers of my father's books.
Okay.
And they held it at a local hotel, which then they had to change locations twice because so many people showed up. And when I finally went into the...
Meaning it got so big that it couldn't fit. So they need to change.
Yeah, they had to change to a bigger venue. And then a bigger venue. And then when I finally stepped up on stage, it was like a sea of people down in this convention center, almost like the convention hall of the hotel. And I couldn't believe it. And I just remember that every other word out of my mouth, everyone would sort of laugh at it. And,
okay. And you're like, what's going on?
Yeah.
What is going on here?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it was really it was a very bizarre experience because I didn't think that I did anything to deserve having so many people pay attention to me. I was still kind of, you know, just coming out of my teens. I was 19, right? About to enter college. And I thought, what is this? And what is this strange place where so many people know about me? And I don't know who these people are. And so that was the beginning of a very strange journey for me.
Wow, but it's hard for, I mean, I guess the audience now, you gotta put this into context. This is pre-internet. This is pre-Facebook and Instagram and young people getting, you know, followers or being known and sort of figuring out how to navigate that. This is pre all of that. And you were just kind of, you stepped into it. And boom, here are all these people.
I think at this point, I'm quite used to actually having people come up to me and say, hey, I grew up reading about you. And I would always say, thank you. And I hope that everything that you see from now on would actually meet your expectations. That's one thing that I think always when I meet new friends, right? And it's a very strange a very strange situation because, just like you said, this was pre-social media days.
Yeah.
Now we have all these influencers, and they build up this curated version of themselves. And they are always, of course, you know, if they encounter someone in the street who recognizes them, then they have probably the same thing going on in their head that I did, except that I had it before all of this was a thing. In college, I studied psychology.
Yeah.
Right. And I studied identity development. Because I think really what happened to me was during that period of time, I had an identity that everyone thought was me. And then I had another identity that was forming within myself. And those two, at some point, had to meet together.
I need people to understand the magnitude of the impact of these stories. You know, like Jim, do you get a little bit of where I'm getting at here?
We're talking about the Truman Show.
The Truman Show. You know, so we see it on a movie, the Truman Show. But bottle rockets, the cops came, and the whole nation reads about it. The whole entire Mandarin world read about it. I still have recollections of that story reminiscing in my mind. Literally, this is like reading Tom Sawyer. This is like the time when Tom Sawyer had his friends paint the fence. Because it was fun, right? remember that? You know what I'm talking about. You know, it's one of those things.
So, right? It's daily life.
Yeah.
It's the stupid stuff that we do as adolescents.
Okay.
It's the things that maybe we get in trouble for, and then we chalk it up as just a lesson learned, right? And then we move on. And these are things that don't necessarily need to come back and become a part of our identity and come back and haunt us continually.
But you know, you and I, Sean and I, we share a lot of similarities. We grew up in a similar way, trying to fit in, mm-hmm. in a new environment. We experience culture shocks and then learning differences between the West and the East.
We're quote-unquote third culture kids.
Yeah, yes, third culture kids. And then later on, moving back into the Asia arena, relearning certain mm-hmm. things from the other side again. There's a lot of friction and spark that could happen from that. And God bless, now that you are a writer, you're sharing new stories, new insights, new understanding, not just from your childhood, but actually from a man's perspective, a father's perspective, a husband's perspective. And you're leading some amazing groups, as I understand, and also doing an amazing podcast. We'll take a little break. We'll be right back. I want to talk to Sean a lot more about what's going on with him recently.